In this video, we're going to be learning some very useful features of the graphing calculator to do some of the things that we're learning in our calculus class. So specifically, we'll be entering a function to be graphed as y1. We'll graph the function in a suitable window on the TI-83 or 84 calculator, so we'll get the graph of the function in front of us. And then we're going to learn how to do two things. First, we'll use the second calc 6, item 6, the ydx menu item in the calc menu to estimate the derivative at a point on the graph. We'll have the calculator do that. And then the other thing we'll do is we're going to use the second and then under the draw menu, item 5, tangent, to draw the tangent line at a point on a curve. And the calculator will actually also give us an estimate of the equation of the tangent line to the graph. So I've brought my graphing calculator up here, and I'm just going to graph a very simple function. So let's go into the equation editor under y equals in the upper left. And let's just plot the function y equals x squared, just a basic parabola. So we'll do y equals x squared. For my window, I'm just going to graph this from minus 3 to 3. An increment of 1 is good. And then since I'm squaring the values, a minimum value of 0 and then a maximum value of, let's just go 9, that'll be the maximum value, maybe an increment of 3. Okay, so this is important. You want to make sure that you actually have graphed the function when you use these menu features. So let's go ahead and hit the graph button here in the upper right along the top row menu items. And we get a nice graph of our function. Okay, so the first menu item I want to show you is how to find the slope of the tangent line, at least approximately to the graph at some point on the curve. So we'll do that with the numerical derivative feature. So this is not plotting the derivative function. The calculator actually can estimate the slope of the curve at a point using this feature. So I'm going to go into the second key here in the upper left. So I'm going to press second, and then I'm going to access the calc menu here. So I'm going second and calc. Let me try that again. Second calc. There we go. And item 5, 6. So I'm going to go down to item 6. And it says dy dx here. And so that's the differentiator that I'll use to find the slope. So that's our Leibniz notation for the derivative. So I'm going to press enter now. And at the curve, what I have to do is I actually have to type a value for x. So let's just type x equals 2 here. So I'm just going to press 2. And then press enter. And when I press enter, it's going to take me to that point on the curve, and it will also give me the slope of the tangent line to the curve at that point. So let me press enter. And so in the display here, you can see that it says x equals 2 and y equals 4. But above the x equals 2, it says dy dx equals 4. And so that's telling me that the slope of the tangent line at that point is equal to 4. Now, sometimes, like this case, the calculator gives me the exact value. There will be other cases where it will only give you a numerical approximation. But in this example, it's actually given me the exact value of the derivative when x equals 2. So, and you can do this at any point on the curve. You just maybe do this one more time. So I'll go back to my second calculate menu, and then press item 6. I'll just go there directly. And maybe we'll do this at minus 2, so or minus 1. So I'll hit minus 1, and then I'll press enter. And you can see that the slope dy dx of that point, negative 1, 1 on the curve, the slope of the tangent line is minus 2. So that's how you can use the differentiator to, when you're computing derivatives of functions and you want to know what the slope of the tangent line, at least numerically, you can get an approximation using this feature. The second feature we want to look at now is going to be the tangent line feature, and the calculator will actually draw the tangent line to a curve and then give you an approximate equation of that tangent line using this feature. So now I'm going to access a new menu. I'm going to go to the second again, but now I'm accessing the draw menu, and you can see the draw menu here above the PRGM, that's the program button, so it's going to be second and then draw, which is above program, so I'll do that, second, draw. And you can see item 5 says tangent, and so that's the tangent line drawer. So if I go to item 5, it'll draw the tangent line to the curve at a point that I specify. And you have to have the graph in the display when you do this, so now I'm just going to press enter. And so let's go ahead and draw the tangent line at x equals minus 2. So again, I have to specify an x value, so I'm going to press minus 2. And when I press enter, it's going to draw the tangent line, and then it'll take a moment, and then you'll see the approximate equation of the tangent line in the display below the graph. So let me press enter, and you'll see what happens. So there's the tangent line, and now you can see why at when x equals minus 2, the equation of the tangent line here is minus 4x plus minus 4. So another way to think of that is minus 4x minus 4. Now the calculator will sometimes only give you an approximate equation of the tangent line, but if you're doing a homework problem and you want to check the equation of the tangent line, you can use the calculator to at least check that your equation is correct. So that's also a nice handy feature. And that completes this video.